Triceratops, and I'm Peter and Josh's best friend, no matter what they say. So I know this is a comedy show, but I'm not actually here to make you laugh. I'm here to ask for your help. My friend John Peavy was walking around with a basket. He and I made the jumbo Hurricane Harvey relief effort to help victims in Houston after the summer. And many of y'all in the audience and on the cheap sucks were amazingly supportive and generous. But Houston wasn't the only city hit. You know, Florida, Puerto Rico, Mexico City, Barbuda. The number of victims seems to be endless, and we want to help as many as we can. So that's why we're passing around a bucket through the audience to collect donations, which are going to be used to help these victims get back on their feet. You can also Venmo at Jumbo Disaster Relief. So look for our Facebook page, Jumbo Disaster Relief Effort, to learn about future events and other ways in which you can help. Because natural disasters are truly, truly devastating. You see on the news what happens for a week, but what you don't see are the months or even years it takes for these people to actually recover. You know, living in Boston, it's easy to forget or oversee just how much trouble this causes, which is why we need to keep raising awareness and keep trying to help as much as we can. When the best your president has to offer is dedicating a golf trophy, that's when you know you gotta stand up. That's when you know you gotta help. So now that we're all warmed up for some comedy, I'd like to give it up to the Cheap Sox!
And we waited all summer for this show because this is the first show of the school year. Welcome, everybody. Let's also just make some noise for the parents that are in the audience. My parents. Funny, fantastic show planned for all of you all.
We hope.
And probably it can happen. The band of, well, no, I'm not gonna say that. Peter, you wanna come in and introduce the first game?
I do.
Awesome.
I do. So, first game we're gonna be playing is a staple at, here in the Cheap Sox community. It's called Pan. So, there are gonna be three scenes happening simultaneously, but don't worry, I'm gonna curate them for you guys. We'll be flipping back and forth between them using a mechanism called Pan. Right. Pan, left. Pan, left. So, we'll be switching between scenes using that. But what I need from you all first is a series of suggestions of relationships. So, that would be like, you know, doctor, patient, brothers.
Clones.
What?
Clones.
Clones.
Teacher, student.
You said that at the O Show. No.
Pirate, captain, and intern.
Oh. Pirate, captain, and intern. Pan, right. Slime and water?
Slime.
A slide. All right, water park attendants. You guys are like the water park lifeguards. All right, pan right in review.
Pirate, captain, intern.
Wait. Pirate, captain?
And pirate, intern.
Like that means the captain of a pirate ship.
And the intern to that captain.
What else would it mean? Review again.
Pirate, captain.
Pirate, intern.
Pan right in review.
Yeah.
Renter.
Hand right, in review.
Water park lifeguard.
Hand right, interview harder.
Pirate captain.
Hand right, interview harder.
Homeowner.
Renter.
Hand right, interview harder.
Water park lifeguard.
Hand right. Hand right. Hand
sometimes think, like, who even cares goes down these slides?
Definitely not me. If a kid went down that slide, I'd be like, who cares?
Jeremy?
Trad.
I feel like we're... I know it's very soon in the summer, but... I feel like we're soulmates.
Trad, bro. Okay, I do too.
Do you ever feel like... who even... Oh, shoot, I already talked
there's
about
a kid drowning. Should we do something about that? Or...
Trad.
I felt the same.
Yeah. I always ask myself, Trad, would you rescue a drowning kid? And if the answer is no...
Awesome!
Hey!
Alright, I did everything you said, boss. I scrubbed the floor.
Ye swabbed the floor!
I'm getting sick of this. Speak to me in plain English, please.
Plain English? What be that, matey? It be the language that the urban elite speak.
Listen, okay? I'm trying to get a good full-time job after college, and if I can't even...
Swab the day.
No. You gave me cotton swabs that are way too small.
You think... I have to be honest with you. I went to Barnard too.
Henry!
Okay. I could expect a, hey, how's it going? You know, maybe invite me in for some coffee. But you just start off too strong with the your rent is due. It's not a nice introduction.
I'm the homeowner. That's what I do. I get your rent.
All right. Do you want my rent? Or do you want the story as to why I don't have it?
Honestly,
because I can tell you the story as to why I don't have that rent. I was walking down the street. Are you gonna sit with me? I was walking down the street one day and I saw someone on the side of the road.
Oh boy.
And he said, hey, can I have $50?
Oh, you handed out my rent.
Oh my gosh. I did.
Henry!
Trav, where are you going?
I am a faithful dude!
Oh, don't forget your floaties, my guy!
Yeah! Honestly, sometimes I think that it's these people's faults for drowning.
It's like, swim!
Can I make a confession to you, because we're soul sisters and all?
Yeah, dude.
I don't know how to swim.
Hit right!
And then, after the economy crashed in 08, I figured, hey, Somalia seems like a pretty important
some of us are worried about the here and now, so I'm gonna need your rent.
You know what?
Yesterday.
Just great. Just great. You're preying on the weak guy. I'll get you your rent. Alright?
I would appreciate that.
And
tell us!
Yeah, so do you think maybe you can hook me up with these Somalian guys after this is all over?
I burned all me bridges with Somalia. I only have one connection now. With Charles Schwab! Just kidding. I have no connections whatsoever.
Tell us!
Try!
Come closer, soul sister.
sister.
Oh, Chad, dude, you cannot die right now. I completely forgot how to do CPR. We were really high at the CPR class. Remember, Chad? Remember, Chad? Remember? Remembering. Chad?
I remember that. I remember everything. And I have one thing. Now that I have this new chance on life, I don't think I could be soulmates with you anymore.
Trap!
See! Called Entrances and Exits. If you're following along in a particularly sharp one, we call it Ease and Ease. You might figure out why. So, what all I'm gonna need from you guys is first a noun.
Potato.
Bird. Potato.
What
do you mean? Jesse.
Potato.
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 And can I get an adjective for Jashy?
Slimy.
Slimy?
Slimy.
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 And can I get a verb for Karen?
Dancing.
Dancing. So, let's quickly review all these.
Potato. Slimy. Dancing. Dancing. Slimy. Slimy. Dancing. Potato. Slimy. No, dancing. 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 Slimy. Slimy.
Backstage of a game show.
Backstage of a game show.
The backstage of a game show. Entrances and exits. So two socks start on, one off. And whenever you're ready, begin.
Boss, I brought you that burlap sack full of potatoes you asked for.
Thank you, Ronnie. Oh man, the contestants are never gonna see this.
Hello, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to sneak backstage. I'm Jennifer, it's really nice to be here. Is that...
Should I ask Jennifer to leave?
Jennifer?
Yeah? Someone told me to come back here.
You're a contestant in this game show.
Yes, that's right, I'm a super big fan, and I love you so much.
This is fine. It's a slimy situation, but I think I may be way, get my way out of it.
Okay, boss.
Be right back.
I don't know if there's something wrong.
Usually we don't really like having our contestants backstage because we like to surprise you on the game show. If you were a really big fan, I think you would know. And so now that you saw our potatoes, we're just in a little bit of a messy, slimy situation.
Oh my god, I didn't want to do that. I can just go. I can go hide. Oh my god, it's fine.
But it's too late. She already knows, boss. Do you see that now?
Where'd she go?
I don't know. She said she's gonna go hide somewhere.
We need sauce for the mashed potatoes. I know this is not making sense right now, but I got a plan. There she is.
Guys, I was trying to hide backstage, but people kept finding me. They're like, what are you doing backstage? Don't you know there's a big surprise?
Don't you know what there is to be hiding?
Oh, yes. Look at the way she's dancing.
Guys, I'm hiding in the middle. I was hiding in the middle. Oh, where'd she go?
She went to talk to the producers of the show. Do you want to sit down and talk for
a second? I would love to.
There's seats right over here.
Sure.
This, yes, thanks.
I'm really, really, really excited for the show, by the way.
That.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
I don't know. Like Sacramento.
How do I say this?
Sure.
Do you want to be famous?
So bad.
So bad. Uh-huh. Interesting.
Mm-hmm. I live like 10 hours from LA.
That's
Yes.
Well, I think I may have a plan to get you famous.
Okay.
You see, right there, mm-hmm. in that sack is potatoes.
Sure.
And we're making mashed potatoes.
Oh.
For the show today.
Yeah.
But we don't have sauce.
Sauce?
Do you see what
I'm
doing?
Oh my god! I've been cooking some sauce! I'll be right back!
No, come back! No, Jessica! God damn it, I knew she was too dumb by her dancing. Jesus Christ.
Director Drawl, the producer really doesn't like this.
I know. God, I'm gonna lose my job today.
I'm gonna lose my job today!
Well, it's not about you, it's about me!
Well, sometimes things can be about me too, you know!
I know, but not today when there's about me. It's Tuesday! God! We need sauce for the potatoes!
Guys, I got you guys so much sauce. Here, take the sauce. This is soy sauce! Who eats potatoes with soy sauce?
That's how we do it in Sacramento!
We don't eat potatoes with soy
sauce!
Don't
eat soy sauce for the potatoes!
Right, she's so dumb!
The station has been bought by cannibals.
So not only are we gonna lose our jobs, but we're also probably gonna lose all of our limbs tonight!
No, because we have her. Get what I'm saying here?
I totally get what you're saying.
We need to find a way to just cut her open and basically have her blood.
What if we mash her in the potatoes?
Okay.
You guys, I got a different kind of sauce.
Jennifer!
Hi! Are you guys happy to see
you? We're so happy!
We are dancing with joy.
You're not dancing.
Knife. Perfect. Keep on dancing.
It's for the show.
It is totally for the show.
Hey, Jennifer.
See. Perfecto. All right, for the next game, it's going to be called Create a Space. We're gonna be creating a room, just one room, and we're gonna ask one of the audience members to come up with Noah over here to mime the objects that are in this room. Is there any brave soul that is really good at, you look directly at me, raise that hand, I love it. Yeah, we're gonna be just a regular scene in a one room, and you guys are gonna be miming the objects.
Cool. All right. So, all along the ceilings are just like thousands of tiny shards of glass suspended by strings, like just above hand height. Like someone who's like 6'3" would be able to reach it, but I'm 6'2".
The room is covered in chocolate. It's knee high. It's a big problem. It's a very big deal.
Whoa.
We're having a hard time.
Yeah. But it's like kind of like a more fudgy chocolate, so it's viscous, it's not like fast drying. The room runs basically from here's one wall and here's the other, but there is a nice shelf at hip length that just runs all the way around.
Beautiful mahogany. You got to see
it. It was on clearance.
There are 12 porthole circular windows spread equidistant. It's very important.
How high? How high?
How high? They're at our ankles, so. It sounds like there's like a big shot. We need that. We're gonna have to clean chocolate off.
Below the chocolate.
Yeah. It's totally not. It's, no. But like, you know, they're there.
It's like we're on top of chocolate. Yeah. You'll know it. Maybe the people in the scene will know it. Who's
here,
to say?
Feel down here. There's like a little bump where you can feel that.
Oh,
beautiful.
Maybe that'll come up. There's two recliners right here. Like they're faux leather. You wouldn't be able to tell by one right here, one right here. They are inscribed with the words Mr. Mahogany and Mrs. Mahogany.
They're both dead. But besides that, we have a beautiful granite countertop also adjacent to
it. Can you show?
Oh yeah, sorry. It's
the dimensions of it.
Yeah, so it's gonna be about yay big.
Perfect. And there are bar stools all around it. There are four. One, two, three, four.
This is a very interesting room. Can I ask just one question?
Yeah.
How the hell do you get in it?
Or out. You get in, but you don't get out.
Alright. I mean, just describe how that would function.
Yeah, no, but how are you going to get into the room? Or what do you do?
You get into the room if you believe hard enough.
If you believe hard enough, that's how you get into the room.
Yeah, alright. And also, there's actually like a very reasonable way to get out of the room, like way up there, but you gotta go through all the shards of glass, so.
That's true.
I mean, who wants to do that?
You might as well just chill, there's a lot of chocolate you can hang out.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Evan, for making this.
So, I mean, there's a reason not actually, yeah, you wanted to spend your time after Mom died. I know it's been hard for you. It's been hard for me too, but this is you know, my way of coping, and I think it's gonna help you too.
I just feel like it's gone a little far, okay? The chocolate, the bar stools, the mahogany, you're sitting in Dad's
right.
chair.
I know. Preserving Mom's chair just as you like.
I just miss them, you know?
Next game that we're going to be playing is going to be called Alphabet Soup. The beginning of every sentence of the scene will be based off the letter of an alphabet.
The next consecutive.
Yes. So to do this, we're going to need a non-geographic location. A therapist's office. So to start the scene off, can I get a letter of the alphabet?
A.
P.
A.
S.
D.
P.
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 Alphabet soup in a therapist's office with a letter P. Begin.
Peter, when did these dreams begin? Last session you told me they were non-recurring.
Well,
Really? Really? The divorce again? Come on, you keep saying everything's because of the divorce. Let's get into the real meat. Your parents.
Sheesh. Give me a personal real quick, Doc.
True. It's my job. Very well, I guess we'll proceed like this.
Whatever. So, the divorce.
Xylophone! You don't deal with spontaneity, though, do you? This is immersion therapy. Think about it.
You really caught me there, Doc. That was a good one. I'm gonna be on you for the next time, though, okay?
Zoinks, that scares me. You're gonna be on me. I'm on you like white on rice, Peter.
Alright, Doc. I'll get deeper.
Alright.
About time you did. About goddamn time.
Canada is where I was born. It's the year 1940. And it was so cold. So cold.
Don't know how I made it this far without knowing your place of birth. Or birth year. Really makes me think. I'm a bad doctor.
Everyone thinks that.
For real? Are you like, no, like, have your other, like, therapist been like, man, I'm the worst? Because, like, I've been having, like, a ton of, like, I've been, like recently, I've just been kind of, like, down on myself.
God, how long has this been going on?
Hey, I don't know, you know, it's just been really something about
I think perhaps you're, something under your layers of doctoring?
Just give it to me straight. What's wrong with me?
You know about that thing called Alzheimer's?
Let me tell you what I know about Alzheimer's.
Maybe you should. Maybe you should, because I know a thing about Alzheimer's.
No, I I just had it. Peter, let's talk about why you're in here. Alrighty, so next we're gonna be playing a game because you know what, I'm a little tired of all this English. We're gonna be playing a game called Gibberish. So first thing we're gonna need is a major favor from someone, Michelle, yes?
Yeah, we've never
met. That she's gonna take Josh out of the room and keep him busy, so it's just gonna show it is better. So we're gonna be playing a game called Gibberish. So now we're gonna get a suggestion of three different things for these socks. They're going to try to convey what those things are to Josh when he comes back in the room using only gibberish. So for the three items we'll need, first is gonna be a movie. Any piece of cinema.
Emoji movie. Emoji.
Shawshank. What?
For
Facebook.
Shawshank.
Shawshank. We're gonna be the Shawshank Redemption. The Shawshank Redemption. Alright, can I get a famous person, historical, contemporary, anything?
Idris Elba.
I heard Idris Elba. Famous actor of Greece. And can I get a historical event? So I'm looking for like a moment, like the Tea Party, like a moment in history.
Waterloo.
Fall of Berlin.
No.
Council of Nicaea.
One more time.
Watergate.
I thought you were saying Waterloo, and I was like, that's a
Watergate.
All right, so we're going to be doing the Watergate scandal. Let's do a quick review.
Shawshank Redemption.
Idris Elba. Watergate.
So now we're going to bring Josh back in, but the English will cease, and the amazing will not. So, let's on three yell, we're gonna yell Pootie Tang on three. One, two, three,
Pootie Tang!
Yeah.
And it's called Try This.
Three shots!
And the catch for this game is that each of these people are going to be speaking for each other. It's called Tri-Dub, and it is awesome. So to begin, we're going to get a non-geographic location per usual. Can I get something from the audience? Is gonna take place in a parking lot. Okay? So, can the sock to my left introduce themselves?
Hey guys, I'm Billy. Sorry, I got a little ash stuck in my throat because I test these parking lots. No, I don't do that. That's my thing when I only do it secondhand when I inhale. I can test the carbon in the ground just in with my tongue, and just, this is my home.
That is very interesting.
Thanks.
Wait, your name again is Millie?
It's Billy.
Billy. Okay. Nice to meet you, Billy. Can the sock in the middle introduce themselves?
Hello. My name is Reginald, and I am the night watchman for this here parking facility. I am in charge of making sure vagrants don't enter the premises, and although we've had something of a rodent issue, I think going forward it won't be.
Whoa! Okay, something spicy. Nice to meet you. Reginald, your name?
Yeah.
Okay. I love the positives. You know, it's very powerful. Can the sock to my right introduce themselves?
Hi. I'm Stella. I'm only six, so I don't know why my parents left me in this parking lot. But I'm just, you know, here to have a good time, make some friends, stay out of vans, you know.
And we want you to be safe. What's your name again?
Stella.
Stella. Nice to meet you, Stella. Okay. Tried up in a parking lot. Begin.
Excuse me, mister. What are you doing?
No, just test in the parking lot. Good job. What are you doing here? Oh, wait, I know you. You're Stella, aren't you? I heard about you, these parking lots, parts, no.
Yeah, well, you build up a bit of a reputation when you're a fun, crazy girl like me.
Vagrant's not allowed. I don't care if it's just for the night.
I don't
God's love also.
You know, I spent my whole life calling you vagrants and rodent and subhuman and disgusting and the scourge of my very existence. But if it weren't for you guys, well, I'd get awful lonely.
What does this mean? Are you guys my new parents now?
We've had a good night of laughs, and a very good night. And as we come to our close, we're gonna play one final game that we saved for Parents Weekend. This game is called Sex With Me. And Sex With Me is gonna just take the place of, you guys are gonna give us a profession or an object, like give us something.
Undertaker.
What?
Undertaker.
An Undertaker.
Undertaker.
Sex With Me is like an Undertaker. The other person's usually not moving that much. So it will either follow that frame or I like my women like I like my Undertakers. I don't have an ending for that, but that's how the other one goes. So it can be I like my men and women like I like my blank, or Sex With Me is like blank, and let's continue with Undertaker.
Yes. Sex With Me is like an Undertaker because I'm always wearing a mask.
Sex With Me is like an Undertaker. By the time we're done, somebody's 6 feet under.
Sex With Me is like